Max.
Let's open it up and see. I can't wait to see your surprise gift.
Okay.
Hey, Amber, what are these pieces for?
I have no idea, Max. I think I'll ask Judy. She may know.
But where is she?
Oh, she is busy preparing for my birthday this weekend.
Hi, Max. Wow, Amber, you got gifts already. That's great.
Yes, Judy. But I don't know what it is. It is a surprise gift. Please tell us if you know about it.
Let me have a look at it. It's a tangram. Hey, there's a poem about it. Let me read it for you guys. I am a mystery waiting to unfold. Pictures, names, and some stories untold. Make square the head or triangle the tail. Place me in order and you'll never fail. Tans are few, but shapes are new. Can you guess me or do you need a clue?
What is a tangram, Judy?
Tangram is an old Chinese puzzle. The puzzle pieces are known as tans.
Okay, but how do we play it?
You can make different interesting shapes using these pieces.
Shapes? But what kind of shapes?
Shapes can be in the form of a bird like the swan, an animal like the cat, or that of a human.
Wow! That's amazing, Judy! Can you teach us how to make such shapes using the tans?
Sure, Max. But first, both should know more about the tangrams. Amber, let's go to your room. I'll get some biscuits to eat. So, shall we start?
Sure, sis.
Okay. A tangram can be a 7-piece tangram or a 5-piece tangram. Usually, the 7-piece tangram is used. The tangram you received as gift is a 7-piece tangram. Let's see the basic shapes used in a tangram. The basic shapes used in a tangram are 1 square, 1 rhomboid, and 5 triangles. You can arrange these pieces in any order and create different shapes. Out of these shapes, there are 2 pairs of identical triangles. And if you look closely, the triangles combine together form a square.
Wow! I never thought these pieces would have so much of importance.
Yes, Max. But you need to be careful. There are some rules to follow for making shapes using these pieces. The first rule is you must use all the 7 pieces. The second rule is all the pieces should be kept flat on the surface. That is, they should not be vertical. The third rule is, all pieces must touch each other. Otherwise, the shape you want to create will not be clear. The fourth rule is, the pieces should be arranged in such a manner that they do not overlap each other. If they overlap, the shape thus formed is not very clear. And the final rule is, you can rotate or flip the shapes to make desired shapes. Now, let's quickly list down the rules. Amber and Max, tell me 2 rules each.
First rule is, all 7 pieces must be used. And the second rule is, all pieces must be flat.
The third rule is, all pieces must touch each other. The fourth rule is, the pieces should not overlap each other.
The last rule is, pieces can be rotated or flipped to make the desired shape.
What is this, sis?
This is the image of a rider made using the tans. Now, you both have to try and make this shape using these pieces.
Wow, that sounds great. So, we are solving a puzzle.
Oh yes, it will be fun. Here, the pieces used are not clearly seen. So, I can help you place these pieces in order too. So, let's start. Let's begin from the head. Can you guess which shape is used for the head? Recollect the rules that we learned.
I think we can use the square by rotating it. Using the fifth rule, which says we can rotate pieces.
Very good, Amber. So we place the square by rotating it like this. So the rider's face is ready. Now who can guess which triangle is used for the rider's body?
I am not sure. There are so many triangles. But I know the shape for the tail. It is the rhomboid.
Very good, Max. You're right. But let's go in order. I'll help you complete the image. If you see carefully, the triangle used for the body is smaller than the triangle used for the horse. But at the same time, it's not very small. So, we will use the medium-sized triangle. And by placing the triangle below the square, we get the rider.
Hey, maybe now I can try.
Sure, Max.
The triangles used for the horse should be big. So, we can place them below the rider. And for the tail, we can place a rhomboid.
Brilliant, Max. Amber, can you complete the image for us?
Sure, sis. Now we are left with these two triangles. So, we can place one of the triangles for the face of the horse. And the other one below the big triangles.
Brilliant, both of you. I hope you liked the game.
Oh, yes. It was wonderful.
Thanks, Judy. I enjoyed a lot.
So gifting Tangram was indeed a good idea.
Judy, so it was you who placed the box at the doorstep this morning?
Yes, dear.
Thanks, sis.
You're welcome, Amber. Hey, kids. Hope you all enjoyed arranging this fun puzzle. Let's quickly revise the important points. A Tangram is a Chinese puzzle made up of pieces known as tans. There can be a 7-piece or 5-piece tangram. The basic shapes in a 7-piece tangram are square, rhomboid, and different shapes of triangles. There are some basic rules to be followed while arranging the tans. They are as given below. All 7 pieces must be used. All pieces must be flat. All pieces must touch each other. The pieces should not overlap each other. Pieces can be rotated or flipped to make the desired shape.